Hey guys, happy week two. It's Monday. I just wanted to check in with you, see how you guys are doing, see what you guys did over the last week. So my son Kaysen, he had a seventh birthday, so that was kind of weird, but really fun. We ended up having like a virtual party. We had everybody on the video chat, and we all ate cake together at our own houses, and it was kind of fun. We opened presents together. We had presents sent to the house instead of delivering them all, but it was really cool. So, hope you guys got to do some fun stuff with your families over this last week. Starting out week two, and I'm wondering how you guys are doing. How are you feeling emotionally? I know this is such a weird time, but I hope you guys are doing good. Remember, when things are going crazy in our life, it's really important that we take care of ourselves, like physically and emotionally. And how we can help ourselves to get through this time is to do things like eat good, make sure you're exercising, drinking a lot of water, getting enough sleep at night. All right. So I wanted to talk to you about some things. I know the weather's kind of changed. Last week we were able to get out, go for walks, do some things outside. Now this week the weather's going to be kind of yucky. So I was trying to think of some fun things for you guys to do that would lift your spirits. And I don't know, some things that you could do to help keep like brothers and sisters going too, because I know a lot of you guys said that you'd be in charge of watching them too. So one of our favorite things to do at our house is just a good old fashioned. A good old-fashioned dance party. So we crank up the tune super loud and we dance, I don't know, three, four, five good songs. That is a great workout. It makes you feel good because the music is awesome, helps get out lots of energy, get the heart rate up, and lots of fun for the little kids too. So that's a good one that you can do. If you don't want to dance because you're like, oh heck no, Miss Hopkins, I'm not dancing. Then you could even do things, just simple things like our warm-ups that we do on PE, push-ups, sit-ups, stretches, bicycles, planks. All those things are really good for your body, especially if you're, feeling anxious or frustrated or just like, ah, I gotta get out of this house, right? I posted a link last week, sent you guys a Skyward message. Hopefully you saw that. Had a bunch of different exercises that you could do. There was some online dance, some online yoga. I had some videos that were kind of like T25, some videos that were kind of like Pio, or not Pio, what's that one we just did? 21 Day Fix. I've been doing that one still. Oh my gosh, it's kicking my behind. So that one's been fun. The other thing I was thinking of, you can get on Pinterest or Interest and look up HIIT workouts, HIIT, high intensity interval, oh, HIIT. High intensity interval training. And those are some really good workouts. They're usually pretty short. They're quick to do, but they're hard. They get the heart rate going, and then you get a little break and heart rate going. And a lot of them have stuff that you can do without any equipment at home. You got stairs by your house? I made Kaysen run up and down the stairs 10 times, and we're charting his progress over Corona quarantine time. So that's kind of a fun challenge for him. If you've got bikes, you can get out and ride bikes as long as you're not touching people. When the weather has a break, you can get out and go for a walk again, just not touching people. I think the biggest thing we have to remember is that we just have to do our part, get this quarantine stuff over with so that we can get back to our normal everyday lives and get back to school. So, while you're not exercising, another great thing you can do to help relieve stress is just get some of that missing work done. So, I know before break, I had just put in, or actually just midweek last week, put in your guys' grades. And I told you if you have any absences, make sure you write down anything that you've done over this time, get it to me, and we'll get you credit for that. The same is probably true for your other teachers. I don't know any teacher out there who wouldn't grade an assignment that you turned in right now. All right, most of us are going to be checking our email. So it's a good time just get that done, turn it in. What's the worst they can say? No, right? And you have learned a little bit and you're more caught up for when we do get back. So I know this is kind of a crazy time right now. We don't really know what online school is going to look like. We're waiting to hear from the superintendent, which is like the big boss of the state, and as well as the Kent School District has to do some talking about how we're going to make all this happen. So hang tight. I know there's not a lot you can do. You've probably already like Netflixed everything you can think of or whatever, but hang in there. I would love to hear from you guys. I miss you guys so much. It's so weird. I'm at home with my 2-year-old and my 7-year-old all day. I miss grown-up conversation. So I got an email from a few of you. I loved hearing from you. I loved getting your messages. So, shoot me a message, say what's up, or tell me what you've been up to. I hope that you guys are doing well, and I will see you next week for my Monday check-in. This is probably around this time because it's nap time. The kids are home. So one's asleep and one's watching YouTube right now. So anyways, exercise, but do your part. Stay 6 feet apart so that we can get back to things. And I hope you guys are all doing well. Can't wait to see you again. Bye.